CrossFit, China, Strange Bedfellows, or a match made in heaven? The branded functional fitness regimen that's been maligned as dangerous and cult-like has withstood the test of time and shed any sort of fad label. 21 years since it was started in a garage in Santa Cruz, California, the US company has grown into a veritable fitness empire. CrossFit gyms, known as boxes, can be found in more than 150 countries around the world. The company was valued at around $4 billion in 2020 before its founder and former CEO Greg Glassman was ousted in a whirlwind of controversy over alleged racist and sexist comments he made. Now, CrossFit has a new man in charge. Former tech entrepreneur Eric Rosa bought the company from Glassman along with investment firm Berkshire Partners. Rosa is a former Oracle executive who does CrossFit and owns his own box. He's put a fresh, progressive stamp on the company and revitalized the sport, as well as its flagship event, the CrossFit Games. What's next for Rosa? Nothing short of world domination. He's looking to expand beyond the estimated 15,000 boxes already in places around the world to find new footholds in places like Brazil, India, Japan, and China. CrossFit already has strong community roots all over North America and Europe, as well as in Asia, including right here in Hong Kong. So, of course, CrossFit is pumped about the idea of tapping the Chinese mainland market. The company is salivating about its growing middle class of about 400 million people with disposable income to spend and trends to follow. At the same time, Chinese President Xi Jinping and his Chinese Communist Party have an unlikely threat to their long-term stability. Obesity rates in the country are skyrocketing, along with chronic diseases linked to poor diet and lack of exercise. China is also one of the fastest aging nations in the world, and its population growth is expected to peak in 2029 at 1.4 billion and then drop off a cliff. That's bad news for Chinese leaders, since astronomical healthcare costs could bankrupt the country. CrossFit now has about 90 affiliated boxes on the mainland, a number that has dropped steadily since peaking in 2017. Rosa has an ambitious plan to have 20,000 boxes in China over the next two decades. The country has already hosted two official qualifying competitions for the CrossFit Games, one in Shanghai and one in Chengdu. But CrossFit has yet to tap a middle class that is embracing fitness and athleisure clothing as well as workouts, not only as a lifestyle, but also as part of a personal identity. Rosa has a proven track record of success, but taking on China is a whole different ball game. For American companies, business in China is now complicated by a trade war started by Republican President Donald Trump. Those challenges look to continue under Trump's successor, Democrat Joe Biden. China's needs and the company's ambitions seem on a course for a match made in heaven, but there are some high hurdles in the way. CrossFit in China? I'll believe it when I see it.